Hey, everybody.
Hi.
I just asked the people we had here before. I know you guys get a lot of questions about what's the next parody episode, and that's what everyone wants to know, but the show is so much more than that. There's like the episodes in between are so emotional, and they feel in the story, and even the parody episodes, there's story in it. So do you feel like the show's kind of getting this reputation, and you have to like keep them up, or to keep the viewers?
Well, you know, heading into this season, we thought really hard about season two and what we did, and you know, we were just talking about the other table. You know, the concept episode sometimes is not. You only have 20 minutes to, you know, tell a story in a single camera half hour in that little show. And when you put a concept into the episode, sometimes the concept occupies a lot of page space. So you have to, you know, use other episodes to dig deeper into the character sometimes. But we do make sure, and it's a maxim on the show, that we have to tell a story in the parody episode, otherwise there's no value for the parody episode. If you're not progressing the characters, then all you're doing is a spoof. And then we're a sketch show instead of a television show. So heading into season three, I think it's really important that we respond to sort of the scope of season two by really digging deeper into the characters and spending a lot more time this season on telling stories about these people. And then we'll probably have just some benchmarks of parody episodes throughout the year, but it won't be the same volume as season two was, just because, you know, in the arc and life of the show, you know,
morphs as you go.
We were talking about the Claymation episode, which is a sad episode for Abed. People remember that it was Claymation, but they not remember like the story that.
Oh, I remember the story. That made me cry, actually.
I called you, and I was in tears.
My voicemail.
I get this message from, Ken called. I wonder what he's joking about. And he's just like, Danny. You and Clay, it's just so perfect. Some Zoe and Christmas, we're going to watch it. I love you. And he like rambled for a little bit.
I didn't ramble.
Yeah.
And then I go, wow, what am I doing in my life?
He started questioning his life and existence.
God, I drink way too much in the morning.
It all started with a Claymation.
Oh, man.
And Dino, he's like,
Dino.
God, of course, Dino, he's just so honest.
He's so honest.
Lost metaphor, it's so true.
God. So depressed right now.
So that's what we're doing. We're all happy to be depressed.
it was so painfully real, and it just one of the most heartfelt moments. And it was on the stop motion. You know, I still get a lump in my throat thinking about
like
it.
I don't know if you could have done that episode or if it would have been as much as real.
Yeah.
You heard all the stuff about the new family and everything. I think it would have been,
a great way to do that.
The stop motion.
It's sort of, I don't know. Yeah. It allows people to the palate of it just a little bit more open.
Keeps people from wanting to kill us.
Exactly. On Christmas.
Yeah, the stop motion did lighten up the tone just enough. For the purpose of the show, absolutely.
I love that characters are allowed to grow and change in the show, but can Abed really experience any growth and still be Abed?
I mean, we talked about that in the Dinner with Andre episode.
Yeah. I think
he doesn't change much.
I think his Dinner with Andre episode is like one of the finest performances I've ever seen.
He's gonna start crying again.
It's so good! It's so good!
For all the other actors jealous of you,
but
you get like my dinner with Andre.
I don't know, I feel very fortunate. I mean, sometimes I'm jealous of everybody else because I'm like, I want to be Vaseline. I want to be Dungeon Master. I think we all get to live out these really like alter ego heroic moments. It's pretty. I love it though. It's fun because you kind of never know what genre we're gonna go with, what genre we're in.
There's an interesting theory online that somebody posted where they said that the study room was purgatory and that Abed was God.
The
members of the study group. And it is sort of true. He is kind of this
That blew my mind.
Yeah. He is a very textured character, but also, you know, it's that I think that objectivity that exists with him that makes him fascinating. And what they were talking about is that, you know, this season we're just going to dig a little deeper into him and what his condition means.
He's going to. I read somewhere that his character is going to be more of an authority figure.
Sure.
Is that going to roll into that new Vice Dean storyline?
It's not. It doesn't involve the Vice Dean.
Not directly.
It involves a different type of authority. We'll reveal that in episode one of season three. You'll see what the new one is.
I think he's a great blend of. And Dan told me all about it. And I was dying laughing because it. It really blends kind of the best of both worlds of Chang from both seasons. You know, Chang's in a position of authority season one, and then he's kind of this lowly student season two. And I really love both aspects of it so much, equally. So it's just great to kind of see, and I don't want to spoil it, what he comes up with. I think it's genius.
What does it mean to you to have done this smaller part in the first season and now you're like part of the main cast?
I mean, for me, it's just when you're, it always goes back to this. When you are a fan of the project you are on, even if you're not on it, it's all I've ever wanted to do is to be on a show like this. There is no such thing as a small part on Community. Look at Magnitude.
Yeah.
Pop. You know, look at Star Burns. You know, he's like an icon now. Look at Leonard. Everyone's got a following.
Yeah.
And all the characters are so richly drawn. And like, you got Vicky, and you got Fat Neil, who Charlie Coons, like, the DD was kind of my favorite episode because of Charlie. He was only in maybe one or two episodes previous to that DD, and he.
Pivotal role,
yeah. Knocked it out of the park. Should have got an Emmy nod for guest star for that. He just was so good in that. And that's what I love about this show, that the amount of attention to detail you give peripheral characters like me and recurring and guest stars, you don't get it anywhere else. And I've talked to like the actors who play Magnitude and Vicky, they're like, oh my god, I didn't know I would keep coming back. And that's what I love about the show. Is that
it's also a great chance to see how the study group is perceived by other people. You know?
Yeah.
And I
love that. Yeah, there was a great scene with Star Burns and Fat Neil and Vicky, right? And, you know,
It's always about them.
It's always about them.
Yeah. Like, so we talk about that, how Jim Winters talks about that. He's like, every time I have an idea, I come to this study group.
Yeah.
I have to tell them right away about this idea I have on campus. We're always like, we are those study groups.
Yeah. It's just great. It's just great when you work on stuff you're a fan of. It's just amazing. It's the best thing.
It's great because they're actually building this college.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
And the more the show goes on, the more you feel like it's a real place with actual real people, and you learn more about it.
We compare it a lot to the Simpsons universe. You know, it's sort of we are a little bit of a live action cartoon in that way. We just keep filling the world out. You know, somebody comes on as a day player to do two lines and they're really interesting, figure out a way to turn that character into, you know, something we can use in the universe.
I mean, like Magnitude for me. I'm in love with Magnitude.
I love in the finale when, first off, Pop. Thank you. Thank you. We agree on that. Everyone here. Now we can move on. Everyone, the level of commitment by every character.
Do you get people calling you up to like say, I want to be on the show, can you get me on the show?
Yeah, I have friends of mine that call me, we're actors, and yeah, absolutely. I mean, this is a universe like a lot of my friends want to be a part of. Yeah, I've been known to refer friends to casting directors and things like that, absolutely.
Any big names?
Well, I mean, I think it's already out there.
Omar
Coleman.
Got another big guy coming soon.
Miniature?
Big in size. In size, that's our only hint.
So, Danny, are you surprised by, I know I follow Reddit. Do you get a lot of people come up to you about that?
I did a Reddit, AMA.
So you did that.
I did that one day. it was incredible. I don't know if you guys have seen it, but you literally just do like a live interview, and then there's all these like threads pop up while you're online. People just ask me questions in real time. To me, have you seen that before?
Have, yeah.
It's incredible, but I think that's sort of our audience too. They're very like on top of our show. If you follow like the, you know, Twitter,
follow Twitter
during
feedback
episode,
after the episode,
it's like people are. I mean, the minute Magnitude showed up, I mean, there was like 6,000 pop tweets.
Yeah.
You know, it's just like things like that. And I think that's really cool to connect to people on that way, because our show feels very like real time, kind of to interact with.
They did a Twitter episode.
They did. I was about to say, yeah, they did a Twitter episode last year. That's
right.
I still have all the characters on my feed because I added them for that.
it's fun though, but it's for us, and that's part of the reason why this is so special for us, because we actually get to connect with all the people who are like, this is their show. You know, Community feels like a fan show.
Yeah. And that's why I'm just dying to go to the panel. You know, this is my first time being here at Comic Con and going, I just want to experience that panel just once right now. Just
yeah, I mean, basically, if we weren't on the show, Ken and I would be here as fans.
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely.
Screaming, crying about the claymation episode.
I know, I would be one of those guys. And I absolutely would. I probably would want to be dressed up as either Ovid or Sir Vern. I probably would. I really would.
I guess I'd be Gary.
That's awesome.
Thank you, guys.